Hey, 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 Bobos, this is your girl, Kat Rabelski, back again on a very short CatLitter story. What? I don't know how I just did that, but it's really because I can't film it the other way. So that's not the point. The point is, boo-boos, we are going not only to dance class tonight, but we are going to our first private lesson with the wonderful Courtney from the ladies room LV. So what I'm most excited about is not only is it my first private with her, but it's also like a one-on-one that I've been dying to have just so I can really start to work more on my craft as a dancer in the sense of like performing artistically, having more face, more attitude, all that fun stuff that I'm really working for, and plus, you know, learning choreography and being better with my muscle and my body motions and whatnot. But really, what I want to get on this little rant about Gant, not only to document my little dance day, but also because I realized people don't understand the basics. Hear me out. What I mean by this, I am not here to be a professional dancer now, down the road, who knows? But really though, it's really for the acting life. But at the same time, dance is a great form, not only of exercise, but body confidence, desires to like, you know, feel yourself, learn better dance moves. Sorry, my nail's breaking. But really though, it's, okay, hold on, I gotta pause it. I was gonna bite my nails, okay. But really though, I know a lot of people, a lot of females specifically, that say they want to be like a professional dancer, they want to be a choreographer, they want to do this stuff and that, but they have no basic training, no fundamentals. When classes are offered, and Ladies LV does this and I absolutely love it, they have a fundamentals class. Tell me why. And I'm not trying to call out anyone, but I am in a sense, because like I have friends who say they want to do this stuff, and then when it came to the fundamentals class, like no, I don't need it, no, there's no point. You can't just look the part and not understand the logistics behind it. It's like when I meet actors who want an agent and want to be an actor, but they don't understand that it actually is work. Like, you have to have training. You have to understand like acting platforms. You have to understand how to do self tapes. You have to understand how to do like all the things. So I don't even have my sunglasses either. But at the same time, I don't get it. If you want to do something, you want to be something in life, you actually have to train. You actually have to, I don't know, have a fundamentals. It's like with sports. I didn't start off as a great athlete, but I practiced, I got the fundamentals down, and I advanced my athletic ability to be what it is, to the point where I can become a physical trainer and actually help others find a better body composition. Yet, I don't understand friends who say they want to be something, but then don't actually get the training in it. So, I don't know if this is like a wake-up call some people need it or I need it in general, but it's so much like, hey, you want something in life, go after it. You want to be the best dancer, actor, performer, doctor, surgeon, physical therapist, trainer, whatever your heart's desires, honey. At the end of the day, you, yes, you have to train. You have to get the basics. And if that means taking a basic fundamentals class just so you know what the freak first position is and how much flexibility you need to gain or add on to your flexibility, then do so. But honestly, I ain't putting up with it. I'm not even trying to become a professional dancer. I just want to be able to have it on my resume. And then when acting opportunities come and they want acting and dancing, I can say I can do both. And proudly, with confidence. So, hello people. If you want something in life, go after it. If you want to do it right, learn the basics, get the fundamentals down, and put in the time and the effort. Because it's not going to happen because you want it to happen. But with that being said, boo-boos, this was your motivation. If you want to do something in life, go get those fundamentals, get those basics down, and have them blast and learn it right. Okay? And that's what I'm going to go do right now with Courtney. And I'm so excited. Hopefully I can video it a little bit. Keep it posted as the dance day continues. Thank you. sweaty. I'm gonna have to shower 3 times today. Not in a bad way. It was amazing. Not only do I have a clip of me doing it, but I loved having the one-on-one with Courtney. Not only is she amazing in a sense as a mentor and a woman and just someone like who supports other women, but also just so down to earth. She's always real with me. She's always honest with me, especially when it comes to like why I'm doing what I'm doing. Like I'm not professional, it's just really for acting, but it builds my confidence and it helps me and it learns more about my body and how I can not only move, but learn about my sexy. Okay, for all of you know who know me, I'm funny. I'm funny, cute girl next door, all that cute stuff. But I've never been told, like, I never thought of myself as sexy. I've never thought of myself as like a sexual, like I'm sexual, but like I'm not like sexy. You know how some women just scream sex? I don't know if I scream it. I'm more like humor and girl next door. But she even encouraged me to like embrace my sexy. Don't come in here, you know, playing off the corny, goofy vibe, even though that's your personality. But like, own your sexy. Own what that sexy looks like to you. And I love that. And it makes me feel so like I don't have to fit in to be sexy, but like I can be my own kind of sexy. And I love that. And through dance, I'm finding it out. And then you'll see in this clip, I feel like I did it. But the more I do it, the more are gonna come. So let's prep. We are going to point our toes, work on some stretches, work our hips for tonight's dance class. I can't wait. So this is the final class before the new, almost new year, last month, whatever. Anyway, it just dawned on me. It was one, my first full year of doing this dance class. Two, even Courtney pulled me aside and said I had made huge progress from last time. And I'm just really excited. And overall, here's what I've learned. One, dance is for anyone. If you want to do it, do it. Find the right group of people. I'm so grateful for the ladies room, LV and and Courtney. Like, I know this is ridiculous, but it's not, because at the end of the day, I'm so grateful for the ladies, because without them, I didn't feel like I had friends. I didn't feel like I fit in. And even though like dance is not like my strongest suit, like we all know I'm an actress, let's be real. But at the end of the day, I love what dance turns me into. It makes me more confident. It makes me love all of my body and my aging. And it's just, it's a woman thing. All right. And it's not even a woman thing. It's a human thing. You're starting to love you and embrace the sexy of you, whatever that is. And everyone's sexy in their own way. And the fact that I love doing it through dance. There might be other ways. People might like painting. People might doing other things. And then do it. Find a group, find a class, and do it. Because when you do something you love, you not only learn more about you, but you learn to love more about you. And I'm so grateful for the ladies, LV and Courtney. I love it. And I hope everyone out there finds something that they love and that they're so excited to do and makes them feel great about them and love them. All right, boo-boos, I'm finally wrapping up this video because I finally remembered to wrap it up. So this has been a vlog about dancing or inspiring to do something that makes you feel more love and feel sexy and confident about you. So whatever that is for you, boo-boos, go do it, okay? And I'm gonna go shower and get some food because I'm exhausted, but it was so worth it. And here's an updated video of what I just did. So hope you like it. I'll see you in the next episode of CatLitter. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. That was so corny, but I don't care. I'm doing it. Okay.
She never went to where she'd go.